Hey guys, it's your girl Yiska, and I am back.
Repping ya on a daily basis. I'm repping ya, I'm repping ya. I'ma rep my king, no matter what they say. Do right by him, each and every day. I will proclaim the glory of his name. His name's Yahweh, the reason I live and have my being. I will not stay quiet.
Hey guys, what is up? It's your girl Yiska here, and as you guys obviously know, this is the first video for this year. I know around this time we should stop saying Happy New Year, however, Happy New Year. It's still early in the year, it's February, and updates. So I gotta update you guys on a few things before I get into this video. I'll try to make this as quick as possible. So, you guys have probably been wondering, where have I been for the past few months, what I've been doing, why no more YouTube videos, why the sudden disappearance? Well, here's a brief explanation. So I started working full-time around October last year, and it has been pretty busy. You know, I know that was later in the year, and I stopped filming videos a while before that. So before I started working full-time, what had happened was, so I have been busy even before I started working that full-time job. I have been getting some things in order. I have been, you know, restructuring my life and different things. You know, it's been very hectic. It's been very difficult to film videos while dealing with everything that I was dealing with. I even, for a brief moment, I stopped using Instagram. Well, I wouldn't necessarily say I stopped using Instagram. I stopped posting on Instagram because I would still check Instagram and, you know, scroll through those feeds and see what's happening. But I was not posting anything for a while. You know, I have to do a better detox the next time I do that detox, or attempt to do that detox. But just to briefly say, guys, yes, I have been very busy. I have been trying to get stuff sorted in terms of the music. I have been investing in myself in multiple ways and all that good stuff. Nonetheless, guys, I am back, and that's what is important. I cannot promise that there will be a full dedication in terms of consistency with uploading videos, but when I do have time, I will try my very best to get videos recorded for you guys. But yes, I am back. So in this video, what I'm gonna talk about is this year, 2020. It's a bit late for the new year, new me stuff. However, I still have some goals that I want to achieve this year. For me personally, this year is all about healing and growth. Yes, healing and growth. Healing on that side of things. Sometimes we go through things in life, we get hurt, we experience a lot of things, and those things are buried deep down within, and we can't seem to get away from it. We can't seem to get over it. It's difficult. I even have a song that's gonna be dropped sometime this year. Only Yah knows. Look out for that one. But yes, there are some things that all of us go through as human beings, and there's some things that we need healing from. And in most instances, we only realize that we need healing when certain situations arise. For instance, lately I have been dealing with some trust issues with friends. I have been dealing with a sense of rejection, neglection. I have been dealing with feelings of rejection and neglect, and when I sat and thought about it, these are all things that stem from past experiences. These are all things that are built on past hurts. You get what I'm saying? They're things that only fluster or only live now because of a past scar. If you guys understand what I'm saying. So yeah, there are some things that I really need healing from. So I'm gonna share with you guys some of the things I have been doing and some of the things I plan to do to help myself throughout this healing process. I also said that part of this year for me is going to be about growth, and that is going to be a big massive chunk of my 2020. Yes. So what I'm planning right now is to fly. Just fly. Like a bird, I'm gonna fly. But really, this year for me, I need to grow. I need to grow in my personal life. I need to grow in my prayer life. I need to grow in my gifts and talents, abilities. You know, my marriage has to grow. My friendships have to grow. Every single thing that I can see with my eyes, feel in my heart, or know of in my mind has to grow this year, 2020. So yes, first thing I'm gonna talk about, or go in depth with, I should say, would be the healing. So some of the things I have been doing to help myself in the healing process, as you guys would have heard me say earlier, I have not been on social media so much for a little while. I have been active recently, but one of the things that I did to assist myself with healing would be coming away from social media, coming away from the noise, being in silence and quiet. People call it a social media detox. That is a great thing to do because you get away from the comments, you get away from the expectations, you get away from all the noise, you just get away from, and it helps you so much. I have been giving myself time away from people, time to heal in terms of my mind. Sometimes the people around us or people that we interact with can impact our process of healing. And when I say this, I mean some people around us may have high standards or high expectations. They may have things that they expect from us, and that may be adding to our pain and our pressure and the feelings of anxiety and all these things that we experience. For me, it definitely has been. I have just been in and out, you know. I haven't been on the scene much, and it has been helpful to me. It definitely has been. So if you guys want to attempt that as a part of your way to assist yourself with your healing process, by all means, go ahead and attempt that. That will be one of the best decisions you ever made in your life. So social media detox. Another thing I have been doing on a very small scale, which I want to start doing even more, is talking about it. Talking about what is bothering you, how it's bothering you, when it has been or was bothering you. I know this sounds cliche, but talking about problems definitely helps. Recently, I had a situation with a friend and I was so hurt. You know, I was hurt by some things that they didn't even know I was hurt by. And I was holding on to this and I was just, you know, acting based on it, which is not a healthy thing to do, so hence I'm healing. And I found that when I actually began to speak and actually began to say what I was feeling, things just completely changed. You know, they didn't even, like I said, they didn't know I was feeling the way I was feeling and about the things I was feeling that way about. So when I began to explain myself and express how I felt, it helped them to have an understanding of what was going on in my mind, what was going on in my heart. And then we were able to work on it, even though it was difficult for me because, like I've been saying over and over again, I'm healing. But talking about it definitely is something you want to practice. While doing that though, I must say, be very careful who you decide to share with. You can't share with everyone. Some people are just negative and that will hurt you more and pretty much hinder your healing process. So you want to be very careful who you speak to. Some of us can speak to our parents, some of us can speak to our grandparents, some of us can speak to an aunt or an uncle or a friend or a spouse if you have one. Just be careful who you speak to and be certain that the person you're gonna talk to about your problems or whatever it is, they can handle it. Because oftentimes I've had people in the past, not so much now because I'm getting wiser, they have told me my problems are too much for them. So when selecting someone you're gonna speak to, be very, very picky, very choosy, to ensure that that person will be able to take what you're saying and not have it depress them or stress them out. While talking, you wanna try to get everything off your chest, say everything that is buried deep inside. And I know that we may vent, but there's some things that we may never say to anyone. Try to get those things out. If talking to someone, and when I say someone, I mean a physical person, doesn't work out for you, or you think that it's gonna be too difficult to come out and speak about anything you're experiencing or any pain you may be having inside and stuff, there's always God. I know this sounds cliche, but really, there's always God. You guys can try what I do personally. I sit and I talk to God as if He is literally right there. So basically, I will go, Father, you know that I don't like this and I don't understand why this happening. I didn't mean for this to happen. I don't like how this is making me feel, you know. I need you to help me. Legit, I literally sit down and I literally speak to God like that, as if He is right in front of me, talking to me or answering me back, like if He's a human that I can see. So that helps me in some cases where there are things that I don't even want to say to anyone out loud for different reasons. So you guys can try that, see how it works. If any of you decide to try that, come back and put a comment. Let me know how it works out for you guys. I want to know how, you know, things that I do, how they work for other people if they attempt it. That's pretty interesting for me to know. Another thing that I have been doing and will continue most definitely to do in the future, that has been assisting with my healing process, writing it down. I actually got this from my godfather, well, in a kind of sort of way. Because you see, growing up, we would have diaries and we would write all our problems and secrets down in these diaries. But to the diary, we would literally write Dear Diary. So what I learned from my godfather is that he was talking about a certain point in his life where he was going through some things. And because it was so painful for him to get it out to say, he would write it down to God. So basically, that is what I do. So I have a little book. And what I do is as you guys already know, who know me, I should say. If you don't know, you're gonna learn now. I refer to God as Yah, which is an abbreviation for Yahuwah, His Hebrew name, who some call as Yahweh. So in this book, I would write Dear Yah, and I would write His, I would say Dear Yahuwah actually, but I would write His name in Hebrew letters. You know, this is just my personal, what I do. And I would write to him and let him know what's happening. I would ask him, okay. I had a specific time that I was very upset about something. So I wasn't happy about the way that I let my anger get the best of me. And I literally came home and I wrote, Dear Yahuwah, please help me to control my anger. Help me to be a good friend despite the situation. Please bring a solution to us so that we can be happy and at peace. And believe it or not, God sees these things. And I know in my heart that He sees these prayers that I write down to Him. So yeah guys, writing in a book or a diary to God is one of the things that I have been doing. I've been doing this for a while actually. 2 years now I've been doing this, or almost 2 years I've been, you know, writing Dear Yah and telling Him all of my problems. So that's something you guys can try as well and tell me how it makes you feel. Come back, leave a comment, let me know how you guys felt after writing your problems out. And of course, again, this may sound cliche, but at the end of the day, this is a godly channel and I have to keep God in the midst of everything. So yes guys, praying is something that works for everything. And I know that it might seem hard, it might feel hard, it might be hard, because sometimes we pray about things, people pray about things for weeks, for months, for years, and nothing seems to change. But God sees and God knows, and everything will happen in God's perfect timing. So praying is another thing that I have been practicing. I'm not going to lie, it has been difficult. As I said, for some people it is. For me, it definitely can become difficult, especially when I pray and it seems as though things are getting worse. How many of you ever prayed and it seems like, oh my goodness, I just pray about this, why is it making a turn for the left? Why is it going south? Why is it going bad? I don't know if the left is the south, just saying, but why is it going bad? We wonder why these things continue to happen or worsen when we just literally just pray to God about it. So I understand how difficult that can be. Nonetheless, you guys hang in there. Everything is going to be just fine. So yeah, those are some of the things I have been doing to assist myself with my healing process. As I said, you guys can try these things. Leave comments down below to let me know how they work for you guys. If they did, if they didn't, the pros and cons of them, whichever ones you guys decide to try. On to growth. So some of the areas that I'm aiming and striving to grow in this year, my relationship with God. How I've been doing that is I have been, as I mentioned earlier, the same thing I've been doing to help with my healing process, I'm doing to help with my growth process in my relationship with, yeah, I have been trying my best to pray differently. I've been trying my best to spend more quality time with, yeah. How does one not spend quality time with Yah either way? Spending time with Yah should be always of quality, if you get what I'm saying. Because if you're spending time with Yah, you're either praying, you're either reading, you're either talking to Him, and you're either worshiping. All that is of quality. So if you're not spending quality time with Yah and only time with Yah, something definitely, definitely, definitely wrong with you. You need saving. So yeah, one of the areas that I'm trying to grow in is my relationship with God. Another thing that I'm trying to grow in this year is my marriage. Of course, of course. God and my marriage. You guys probably like, yeah, we already know all the things you're trying to grow in, sis. But yeah, literally, I'm trying to become a better wife, a better sister, a better daughter, a better friend. Everything that I am in this life, I want to be the best at it that I possibly can be. So some of the things I've been doing to become a better wife are, I've been reading. So what I've been reading is this book. It's called For Women Only. It's probably gonna be flipped. I'm just gonna flip it for you guys. This book is awesome. This book was given to me by my dear friend Krista, and she gave me this as a wedding gift. I love this book so much. Right now I'm at around page 78. I am not through with this book as yet, but this book is a great book. The author's name is Shanti Feldhan. In this book, there is a lot of explanations for us women, because it's for women only. It's a lot of explanation on men. It's a lot of details about their minds and how they think and how they feel. And reading this book has helped me to make so many changes in the way that I go about dealing with Diego, because it helped me to understand how his mind works. So whereas before I would do certain things and not even, you know, bother or feel any way about it, reading not even halfway through this book as yet, I have been able to change things, because I know that if I say this, he's gonna feel insecure. If I say this, he's gonna get upset. If I say this, he's gonna feel as though I don't need him. So it's helping me to really understand Diego and make some changes. And in one of these chapters, she made a suggestion that the man should read her book for men only, while I, the woman, read for women only. And through it, we should highlight things, you know, highlight things that she says that's accurate and true, and switch so that I'd be able to see what Diego highlighted, which is some of the key points that he would be feeling personally as a man, and he would be able to see some of the things I highlighted that, you know, he would be able to see that I deal with personally or relate to as a female. So that's one of the things I've been doing to help myself grow in my marriage and become a better wife. Of course, praying for the marriage as well, trying to spend more quality time together with my husband, trying to pray more often together, trying to read the Bible together, have more heart-to-heart conversations, speak about things that bother each other in love, you know. So another area of my life that I'm trying to grow in this year will definitely be self-love. The way that I see myself, the way that I embrace myself, the way that I think about myself, I have definitely been trying to change that and improve it. Some of the things I have been doing would be, as some of you guys would have noticed, I would take more pictures smiling, because everyone should know by now who knows me, I am very insecure about my teeth. I have been very insecure about this. When I was younger, people made a lot of jokes about me, and oh, a car could park between there, a house, you could put a whole city between your teeth. You know, kids not nice, just hateful, man. It's something that I have been insecure about my whole life. Another thing that I'm insecure about is my face, because basically growing up, I would suck my tongue. So because of that, yes, my tongue is heavy. That's normal for people who suck their tongue. It's not like terribly heavy to where it's protruding or anything. But because of the constant movement of sucking my tongue, my jaw has been a bit disfigured. So one of my jaw, I don't know how to explain it. One of my jaws are bigger than the other, and it's very uncomfortable for me. And what I've been doing to help myself with that is trying to make myself believe or keep telling myself that I don't need to get a surgery because I have a protruded jaw. I also have an underbite because of the act of sucking my tongue as well. It has pushed my jaw forward. So from a side profile, you can see that my jaw is protruded. Underbite simply is, for those of you who don't know, my bottom teeth are over my top teeth. So if I want my top teeth and my bottom teeth to touch, I have to pull my jaw back, which is very painful. And that would pull my jaws up, that my face would not be, my chin would not be long, and it would not constantly look as though I have a long face when I'm not annoyed or not pissed off, and people just be like, "Why your face better? Why your mouth jerko?" And I just be like, this is just how I look. I ain't annoyed. I ain't sad. I ain't upset. It's just that I got an underbite. It's not nice. It's not cool. It's not pretty to have. But I am trying my best to tell myself, you know what? You can live. You don't need to get a surgery. Like, who you gonna look good for either way? It don't about a day ago. Like, another thing that I want to improve in my life is my music. My musical career, I want it to exist. As of right now, I do not have a musical career. I'm just a regular artist out here struggling. So one of the things I want to do this year, as I said earlier in the video, I have been investing in myself. I have been learning to mix, master. I have just been investing in myself, guys. So basically, that's it. Those are some of the things that I am looking to grow in this year. Those are some of the things that I've been doing to help myself in the healing process. I hope that my journey continues to inspire you guys. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you guys like this video, learned anything from it, can relate to anything in it, don't forget to like the video, leave a comment down below, and if you have not already subscribed to my channel, what are you doing? Go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Share this video with your friends if you think anyone needs to hear it. Thank you guys so much for being patient with me always, for being supportive of every part of my journey. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I will see you in my next video. It's been your girl Yiska. Shalom.
This beat ain't normal. Papa God give me life, oh.